Hello students, today we will study parameters influencing structure and quality of rotors banyans. For this topic you can study these two books, New Spinning Systems by R.B. Mahendra Gowda, NQT Publications, IIT Delhi, and Ritter Manual of Spinning, Alternate Spinning Systems by Dr. H. Stalder, or New Spinning Systems by H. Stalder. So under this topic, we will study that what are the parameters which are affecting yarn structure and quality. So broadly speaking, we can classify parameters in two sections. Number one is process parameters and second is fiber characteristics. So we will start from the process parameters. Under the category of process parameters, we will study opening roller, wire profile, and next is opening roller speed, that what is the effect of increase or decrease of the opening roller speed, then rotor speed, that what will happen if we increase or decrease the rotor speed. Third is rotor dia, that which diameter is suitable for different types of fibers and on what factors the rotor diameter depends upon. What should be the wall angle of the rotor. And then we will study about the groove, that what should be the groove angle, and what should be the groove shape, because groove is an important part of the rotor, and geometry of this groove is very important and affecting the yarn properties. Then what is the effect of draw of nozzle, and how many kinds of nozzle or navel we are using in open end spinning, and what is the effect on the yarn properties, that we will study in detail. And today we will study and start with effect of opening roller wire profile. As you know that sliver is fed, and after feed roller the material is coming in contact with the opening roller, and this opening roller is clothed with sawtooth clothing, metallic clothing, and as in the case of carding, the carding action depends upon the specifications of the clothing. In the same manner in rotor spinning also, the specifications of the opening roller are very important, and proper selection of the wire points of the clothing of the opening roller is very much necessary. In rotor spinning, we can process different kinds of fiber. We can process cotton also. We can process man-made fibers. We can process blends also. And some people have tried acrylic fiber also, and blends of acrylic also, viscose fibers and its blends. So for different kinds of fibers, we should have different clothing of the opening roller. So the basic principles are same as in case of carding, that cotton requires more opening, and man-made fibers are easy to open. They require less force to open. At the same time, impurities are more in cotton fiber, and there are negligible or very less impurities in man-made fibers. So the clothing of different fibers should be different, and their specifications should be different. So in this case, it is shown that what should be the specification for processing cotton fiber and polyester fiber, so or man-made fibers. In general, we can say that a low teeth angle is required for gentle treatment. The fibers which require gentle treatment, so all man-made fibers require gentle treatment because they can easily be opened and impurities are very less or negligible. So in case of cotton, suppose angle is kept 25 degree, then the angle of the wire points is kept 12 degree for man-made fibers. Pitch, that is the space distance between the two consecutive wire points, is 2.1 mm in case of cotton, and it is 3 mm in case of man-made fibers. Height of the wire points is 4 mm. It can be more or less also. And in this case, in this diagram, it is shown that total height of the wire point is 4 mm, where height of the base is 1.8 mm, and height of the wire point, effective height of the wire point is 2.2 mm, which is individualizing the fibers. So the total height is 4 mm. So in this diagram, it is shown that what are the specifications of wire points for cotton and man-made fibers. So this is not ultimate, and this is not hard and fast. Depending upon the fiber to be processed, depending upon the different conditions, we can change the angle as well as pitch, as well as other specifications of the wire points. This is just an example to show that how we should have different clothing for processing different fibers. Next is effect of opening roller speed. Opening roller speed is determined by the extent of fiber individualization required for the fiber, because opening roller is opening the fibers and individualizing the fiber. Fiber to fiber separation is there. The material is coming in the form of individual fibers. So how much should be its speed? That is important. In the industry, generally, we are optimizing the opening roller speeds. We are taking trials and we are studying the yarn properties, and we also study that what is the yarn tenacity imperfections. We can also find out the tenacity of the fiber also, that if fiber damage has taken place, that we should come to know. So increase in opening roller speed, it results in first tenacity increases and then it decreases. So we have to find the optimum point at which the tenacity of the yarn is maximum. So at this value, the opening roller speed should be kept. Now the question is there, why first increases and then it decreases? Because initially fiber individualization is achieved. Suppose we are keeping the speed 6,000 RPM, then 7,000 RPM, then 8,000, then 9,000, and then 10,000 RPM. So initially, for suppose 6,000 RPM, the individualization is achieved. But after that if opening roller speed is increased, then this increases centrifugal force of the opening roller fibers associated with the opening rollers. The fibers are thrown against the walls of the rotor and leading hooks are formed. So this will disturb the orientation of the fibers. So even then, we are still increasing the speed at very high opening roller speed after a certain level. It may cause fiber breakage also. So we can have different effects of opening roller speed. So it depends which fiber we are processing and at which level of speed we are moving. So we should optimize the speed. Suppose at 8,000 RPM, we are doing experiment of 6,000, 7,000, 8,000, 9,000, 10,000. So it may be possible that we are getting good fiber utilization at 6 and 7,000. Then we are getting maximum tenacity at 8,000. And after that, the tenacity is less at 9 or 10,000. So then we should keep the speed of the opening roller 8,000. So that is the optimum speed. So in this way, we can decide the opening roller speed. So opening roller speed should be such that hooks are not formed when the fibers are transferred from opening roller to the valve of the rotor, and fiber breakage should not take place. So in this way, we can decide the opening roller speed. And today we have studied two points. Number one is effect of closing of the opening roller, and second is effect of opening roller speed. In the next lecture, we will discuss effect of rotor speed, that what rotor speed we should keep. So with this, I finish this lecture here, and we will continue our discussions in the next lecture. Thank you.